GRDC harvester setup guide is designed to help you maximise the capacity of your harvester and minimise losses. Hopefully the guide provides you with some tips and tricks to improve your harvesting performance.
So the importance of threshing system setup, everything that this machine is doing revolves around threshing. So how does that occur? So in a hybrid system, we're going to have a conventional full-width drum and concave. And in our rotary machines, it, believe it or not, is exactly the same. We've just turned it 90 degrees. The importance of getting it right is the most important and most fundamental part of harvesting. This section addresses the issues that result in poor performance of your machine and threshing losses. Our threshing process is the complete removal of all the grain from our heads, and then the separation of all the grain from the straw, and then we have to deal with all of the mog that is created in that process. Remember that poor threshing setup will lead to poor performance and increased losses. So if we are not square, if we are not got it set up correctly, we are going to lead to losses. We're going to move the material, put it not where it's supposed to be, and that leads to losses. Remember, loose is fast.
So grain cracking, how can we stop grain cracking going into our machines? So we've got our concaves and our rotor. So if our machines are running unloaded, so in a light crop, we want that machine to be as full as possible to prevent our cracking of our grain. If we've got incorrect concaves in our threshing system, we can have a lot of grain cracks happening there. Our rotor speed is also another important thing that we need to look at. The higher the rotor speed, the more chances we've got for grain cracking. When we look at our concaves and rotor setup, it's really important to have that level. If we've got our concave sitting on an angle and we've got our rotor sitting on one angle, the distance between the front and the back of our rotor setup and concave setup will be incorrect. We want those to be parallel. We want the gap between the front, the middle, and the rear of our concave setup to be absolutely perfect. If we do that setup correctly, our grain losses and our grain cracking will reduce dramatically. If we can keep our straw length a foot or a couple of feet long to come out of the back of our header, that's what we want. If we take a long straw, we can't hide any grain in that straw. But once we take that straw and we crumble it up and it's a small piece of trash sitting in our hand, we can sit our grain in it and we can lose that grain. So that's why straw length, to keep it in one piece, that's really important for us.
So on all Case IH machines, we need to square and parallel our concave measurement in relation to our rotor. So we get our ruler and we do our measurements in four points. At 6 o'clock at the back of the concave, at 6 o'clock at the front of the concave, and we set those two parallel using the adjustment link. We then do the two side measurements where we go and measure from the second bar down on the top of the concave, this point in here, to the skin of the rotor, and we set those the same as we do our bottom. That gives us our square and parallel. Your operator's manual will tell you those measurements and will tell you how to set that square. In my opinion and my personal experience, we will move that concave right of the center or zero position for best performance. In your operator's manual, when you're measuring the left side measurement, it will tell you to measure the third bar, but the factory is counting the frame that you attach it into the H-frame with. So when you get it, it will be the actual second available one, which is your third bar. If you square your concave as per the operator's manual, your pinch point will be at 6 o'clock. In my experience, the most desirable position for this is 8 o'clock. So moving your concave right will lead to the pinch point moving into that area. This pinch point on a flagship machine then becomes where we always set the pinch point on the smaller machines. In my experience, this leads to reductions in losses and increases in capacity in tough or difficult conditions.
New Holland CX concave needs to be set as follows. At the front of the concave, the rasp bar needs to be 10 millimeters away from the thrashing bar. And the rear, the same, 10 millimeters away from the rasp bar to the thrashing bar.
When it comes to our threshing system, it's very important to have our concaves and our rotor level to each other. For example, if we've got our concave sitting like this, on an angle, we've got our rotor sitting here, we've got a very big gap at the front, we've got a smaller gap in the middle, and we've got a smallest gap at the back here, your threshing is not going to happen the way that you want it to happen. If you've got a 10 mil gap sitting in the cab, you might have a 15 mil gap at the front, you might have a 10 mil gap in the middle, and you might have a 5 mil gap right at the back. So your threshing is not going to happen at the front, it might happen in the middle of the concave, and it will thresh and break your grain at the back end here where your gap is too small. So it's very important to do your zeroing of this on the machine. That is the two arms that you use to do your zeroing. We recommend that you ask your dealership or your harvester expert to help you with it, because if you do it incorrectly, there might be some dramatic failures of your machine. Our pinch point is sitting here at 8 o'clock on our John Deere harvesters. So we need to set that pinch point to make sure that the front of the concaves and the rear of the concaves are even. That's the way where we adjust it with those two bolts. Once we pull our concaves up and it starts touching our rotor elements, we back it off a little bit. So that way we can have about a 5 mil gap between our rotor element and our concave interrupter bar.
Selexian concaves can be particularly difficult to set up, and you may require dealer support or dealer assistance to do it. In general, what we're looking for is a 7 mil bar clearance at the front of the concaves on both sides, and a 4 mil bar clearance at the rear of the concave, also on both sides. This will achieve the best results. The use of spiked or hooked ras bars in preference to the use of the standard ras bar will give improved separation performance in all machines that have this style of ras bar. This one is a hooked or a spiked ras bar. It is a separation aid. It is used to open the crop mat and agitate it and improve separation. This is a standard ras bar, which is a threshing element. It will move material, but it's to improve its separation ability, we would replace it with another hooked or spiked ras bar. The standard ras bar feed or lead-in angle from C&H is 24 degrees. There are, however, available other manufacturers' ras bars, and they can come in either a 10 or 28 degree feed angle. That will either slow the crop flow or speed it up, and these may aid separation in certain circumstances.
Rotor vanes are designed to move straw out of the concave area and clear the threshing area. As a rule, the vane should be advanced as far as possible. When the rotor vanes are back, they hold the straw in the threshing area longer. This retained straw is ground up and the grain will hide in it. Over-threshed straw may carry grain out of the rotor and drop it too far back on the sieves, leading to loss. Having a longer straw that is ejected from the concaves quickly will help improve output and reduce grain loss.
Optimizing threshing capacity is affected by a number of things. So, selection of concave clearance or gap, right? Drum speed or rotor RPM, okay? And start with the crop type. So just remember, a smaller grain will need a smaller gap and a higher RPM. A larger grain will need a larger gap, but a slower RPM to optimize that threshing ability. Establish a threshing threshold. What we mean by that is unacceptable levels of loss, dirty sample, and then tune according to crop type from there. The steps for determining where you go from here, okay? So we want to open our concave as wide as we possibly can and still achieve threshing. That then retains straw integrity, which aids separation and leads to a cleaner sample and a lighter sieve load. Another thing that we can tune is our drum RPM. Okay, so speed the drum up or the rotor up until it stops thrashing and then slow it back to find an acceptable point.
Looking at our fan, I would recommend to start off with our recommendations that we've got in our operator's manual. When it's early in the morning, conditions are a little bit tougher and there will be high moisture in our stalks, we can boost our fan speed up by 30 to 50 RPM above our operator's manual. During the day when everything is nice and hot, our threshing is a lot easier, we can drop our fan speed down again by 30 to 50 RPM. We need to make sure that we make one adjustment at a time. Don't make any more than one adjustment at a time, because that can get confusing to see which one solved our problem. We need to set a benchmark, so get that benchmark during the day, and then we can go up or down from that benchmark to see where it's the best. I have seen that our fan speed runs a lot of time. We run our fan speed too low. Don't stress about getting your fan speed up a little bit to get a cleaner sample and prevent losses from going over our top sieve. When it comes to settings, we can't just have one setting all day that we start off in the morning and work till 1 or 2 in the morning. During the day, we need to make changes to our settings all the time. So we might have a start off setting where we start off at 10, 11 o'clock in the morning with, and then during the heat of the day, 3 or 4 o'clock in the afternoon, we might make a few more changes. We might have to drop our fan speed back. We might have to open up our concaves. We might have to drop our rotor speed back. And then one important thing that we normally forget to do is our ground speed. Our ground speed is the biggest change in our settings that we can make. So that ground speed might speed up during the afternoon when it's nice and hot, and then at night time and in the mornings when it gets tougher, we can pull our ground speed back to the amount of material that comes through our machines. Other settings that we need to keep in mind of our machines will be our knife and our knife guards. Make sure they are nice and straight and sharp. There's also lodge crops that's going to have an influence. It's going to be wet paddocks that's going to have an influence. If you've got a lot of wheat in your paddocks, that's going to have an influence in your header. So all of these things you need to take into consideration when setting your machine up.
So maximising the threshing capacity involves bringing as much material into that threshing system to process as we can handle. That might mean making some incremental changes to the concaves, or to rotor speed, or to ground speed. Use this approach to set your benchmarks to get the most out of your machine. For a rotary or axial flow combine, open the concave to increase input and increase the rotor speed in 50 RPM steps. For conventional tangential or hybrid combines, open the concave 25 to 35 millimetres. Set the rotor or drum speed at about 850 to 900 RPM and increase the drum or rotor speed in 50 RPM intervals at a time.